Kindness. Actually, sa totoo lang, ako, ang take ko dyan is kindness is innate in each person. In fact, sa atin lahat, kindness is just waiting to come out. But for some reason, because of our hurts, our biases, our fears, minsan hindi natin pinapalabas si kindness eh. Pero kung pabayaan mo lang, I think it's natural for every person to be kind. That it's a natural tendency for people to be kind. Yun lang, minsan ayaw mong palabasin kasi natatakot ka na masaktan, natatakot ka ma-betray, natatakot ka ma-perceive na innocent or naive, or gusto mo lang maging cool, ayaw mo masyado magpalabas ng kind ka kasi it's not that cool. Diba? May mga ganyan klaseng weirdness in our thoughts. But I think in each and every one of us, kindness is always trying to come out. The kindness in us always tries to come out. Kaya, di ba pag nakikita ka ng taong nasasaktan, you're moved. Pag nakikita ka ng tao, if you see somebody na who's hungry or who's hurt or who's crying, you wanna reach out. Di ba? Being kind is healthy for you. And I think that's the natural order of things in the world. And so the challenge really is let it out and just be kind, because that's what comes naturally in all of us. Honesty between two people is important because it's two souls coming together, diba? It's two minds, it's two hearts, it's two souls coming together. So when you're honest with one person, your soul connects. That's how I feel. That's yan yung interpretation ko dyan. Which is why honesty is very important. Because you allow yourself na i-bear mo yung soul mo sa isa. And then the one who accepts it honestly can do anything with that. So dishonesty is the opposite. No? The dishonesty is something that people abhor. Kasi in-open up mo na nga yung soul mo eh. Ang hinihintay mo lang naman dyan is what would that other person do in return. But if the other person is dishonest, yun, yung pag-bear mo ng soul mo sa kanya, kung anong gagawin niya dun, yun yung hurtful, di ba? Pag nilaro niya or binetray ka niya. So that's why I think honesty is a really, really important trait to have. And it's really something na people have to learn to do more. It's important to keep talking to God because sa totoo lang, the mystery of life of any person, there's always that question, what am I doing here? Or why am I here? Or what am I here for? Diba? Yun yung mga existential questions in life. And really, you know what? You will never, never really know the answer. And yung buhay ng tao is really a life of trying to find that purpose and meaning in life. So, where will you find the answers? You find the answers from the Creator. And the Creator is God. So you always have to keep constantly praying and communicating with God because you wanna know. You want Him to send you a sign. You want Him to let you know or move you towards where God wants you to go. Kasi, if you are doing what God wants you to do, things come easy eh. Pansin niyo yun? When you're doing what God wants you to do or where God leads you, things just fall into place. They just fall into your lap. And then this just shows you the way. So you have to keep talking to God and asking Him to show me the way, lead me, give me a sign. And the signs can come from either in your heart or in your mind or through other people. You will meet people who will lead you towards the right direction. Mahilig ba kayong maglaro ng mga games na ganyan, di ba? Sa games, di ba? You're always moving and then you go to a friend and then the friend tells you what to do, right? That's how games are made, di ba? Yung mga ganyan. How else will you know unless your character meets another character at sasabihin sa'yo yung mga clues? Where was that based on? Life. Ganon din yan sa buhay. And so, you just have to keep talking to God because if you forget to talk to God, you will find yourself lost and unfulfilled. And I think inevitably, ang buhay ng tao, all you wanna do really is just feel fulfillment. And you will feel fulfillment if you are accomplishing the work that God has assigned to you on this earth. Siguro, ang pinakasagot ko dyan is, life is short. Short enough for you to either enjoy it or not. If you keep looking and thinking about so many regrets, hindi mo ma-enjoy ang life. Minsan, mas mararamdaman or ma-realize mo yan when you are with a close person, family member, who is in their dying bed. Marami siguro makarelate niyan. Yung pinaka nakakalungkot talagang isipin is if you're with someone that you love who is in their dying bed. Pag namatay ka kasi, gusto mo mamatay ka na wala ka talagang regret. The most peaceful deaths that I've seen, no? And siguro in my work, I've seen many, no? I have friends or family members who I've seen who passed away. Ang makita mo talaga that if a person has no regrets, mas peaceful yung death. And I think that should ultimately be the aim of everyone. Kasi alam naman po natin, ang buhay may hangganan. Lahat naman tayo may ending, no? Ang pinakamaganda, yung ending mo, yung parang wala kang regret. Alam mo how you will have no regrets? I think the best way to think about it na para wala ka talagang regrets is isipin mo lahat ng pinagdaanan mo sa buhay is all just part of the adventure. Masakit man, masaya man, nasaktan ka man, nakasakit ka. It's all part of the beauty and glory of life. Wala namang ibibigay sa'yo ang Diyos na hindi mo kaya, di ba? So, dapat maniwala ka dun. At lahat naman ng mga pinagdaanan mo, kahit gaano mang kahirap, eventually, nakayanan mo naman eh. No regrets, di ba? Para happy life and eventually, happy ending ka rin pagdating sa dulo ng buhay mo. At wala kang bagahe na iiwan. Kasi pag nawala ka dito sa mundo, hindi rin maganda na yung iniwan mo, isipin nila na ang daming regrets, di ba? So, yun lang. Just enjoy the ride and be happy. So that's all I have for you today. If you found value in today's episode, make sure to hit that subscribe button and put your comments on the comment section below. I'll see you again in the next video. Ingat!